Hello students, in last session we discussed about the relation between temperature and resistivity. For a conductor, resistivity increases due to increasing temperature. In case of alloys, resistivity does not depend on temperature, or other words we can say that there is a weaker dependence of resistivity with temperature. And in case of semiconductor, if temperature increases, then resistivity decreases. So now, today, we discussed about electrical energy and power, topic number 3.9. Now in 11th standard, we discussed about power. So, the definition of power is energy per unit time or work per unit time. So, now before discussed about power, we first of all we know about electrical energy. So, for this just concentrate in figure shown to you. In your figure, a conductor of resistance R is shown. The one end of the resistance is known as A and the another end of the resistance is known as B. Current is flowing through this resistance is from A to B as shown in figure. Suppose the potential at point A is VA and potential at point B is VB, then from this figure we can say that point A is at higher potential than VB. Because whenever your current is passing through the resistance from A to B, then current suffers due to the resistance of the conductor. So at A, potential is high, while at B potential is low. So from this I can VA is greater than VB, then from this figure I can say that the potential difference across AB is, suppose V, then V can be written as VA minus VB, and VA is greater than VB, so we can say that is greater than 0, or another word we can say that V is positive. Now in time interval delta T, delta Q amount of charge is flowing through this conductor, then according to definition of current, we can say that delta Q is equal to I delta T. In time interval delta T, delta Q amount of charge is flowing from this conductor, then delta Q can be written as I delta T. So according to definition of potential energy, so you know that potential energy is potential energy at A is, suppose UA, then UA can be written as Q into V, that is Q charge, and V is the potential at point A. And instead of Q, I can write here delta Q, because delta Q amount of charge is flowing through this conductor. And the potential energy at point B is noted by UB, then UB can be written as delta Q into VB. You know that the formula for potential energy U is equal to Q into V. So by using this formula, I can write here the charge is delta Q and potential at A is VA, and at B the charge is delta Q and potential is VB. So it is Q delta Q into VB. Now change in potential energy is suppose noted by delta U, then you know that change in potential energy is final potential energy minus initial potential energy. So final potential energy, that is potential energy at point B, and initial potential energy, that is potential energy at point A. So delta U can be written as UB minus UA. But UB is equal to delta Q into VB, and UA is equal to delta Q into VA. So take delta U common, delta Q common. So now my equation for change in potential energy is delta Q into bracket VB minus VA. But see here, VA minus VB is equal to V. So definitely VB minus VA is written as minus V. So here you can write VB minus VA is equal to minus V. And what about delta Q? Delta Q is nothing but I delta T. So substitute here, delta Q is equal to I delta T into VB minus VA is minus V. So take this negative sign here. So I can write this relation like this way, that is I V delta T. What is the meaning of this negative sign? So change in potential energy is negative. It means your change in potential energy is less than zero. And negative sign indicates here your final potential energy is less than initial potential energy. That's why your change in potential energy is negative. Now, according to law of conservation of mechanical energy, we know that is potential energy E is equal to kinetic energy plus the mechanical energy, or in other words we can say that total energy. So total energy E is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So from this we can say that is change in kinetic energy is equal, change in total energy is equal to change in kinetic energy plus change in potential energy. So now see, law of conservation of mechanical energy, it shows that mechanical energy is constant. So change in mechanical energy is definitely zero. So this equation can be written as 0 is equal to delta K plus delta U. So what is the meaning of this? So from this, if I take this delta U this side, so I can write it like this way, that is minus delta U is equal to delta K. Or if I change the position, then I can write it, that is delta K is equal to minus delta U. But we have already derived the equation for change in potential energy, that is change in potential energy delta U is equal to minus I V delta T. So substitute here, so our equation becomes change in kinetic energy is equal to minus I V delta T, that is I V delta T. See here, our delta K is positive, change in kinetic energy is positive. It shows that your delta k is greater than 0. Right, your delta u is negative. It means your delta u is less than 0. And kinetic energy, change in kinetic energy is greater than 0. It means your during the motion of charge in a conductor, its kinetic energy increases and potential energy decreases. It means we can say that whenever our charged particle is moving in a conductor, they gain some energy, and due to this, its kinetic energy increases while its potential energy decreases. In topic of drift velocity, we discussed about this. Whenever our charged particle is moving in an electric field, then the acceleration of this charged particle is zero, right? And our drift velocity does not depend on time duration. So whenever our charged particle is moving in a conductor, this charged particle collide with ions, and during this collision, ions gain some energy from the charged particle. That's why the potential energy of charged particle decreases and ions gain some energy, and due to this energy, the vibration of positive ions increases. And due to this, due to increasing vibration, the time interval for collision decreases, and this collision converts, due to this collision, the temperature of the conductor increases. Clear? Whenever charged particle is moving in a conductor, this charged particle collide with the ions, and this charged particle lost some amount of energy, and this energy is gained by the ions, and due to this energy, the vibration of positive charged particle increases, and due to this, the temperature of the conductor increases. So here we can say that this temperature is increases. This shows that electrical energy is dissipated in form of heat energy. So heat energy produced, or heat energy produced in a conductor, in time interval delta t, is, suppose delta w, then I can say that this delta w is equal to delta k. Work is equal to change in kinetic energy. So work is equal to delta k, but delta k is equal to IV delta t. So I can write here work is equal to IV delta t. It shows that the energy, electrical energy, is dissipated in terms of heat energy. So the heat energy produced in time interval delta t is equal to delta w, and that is equal to IV delta t. Now from this we can derive the equation for power, because we know that power equal to work or energy per unit time. That is, power can be written as, in mathematical form, that is power P is equal to delta W upon delta T. Delta W is equal to IV delta T upon delta T. So delta will be cancelled. So our equation for power is VI. This is the first equation for power. But according to Ohm's law, I can write here V is equal to IR. So substitute here value of V for I, then I can be written as V by R. So substitute here value of I in this equation. So V into V by R. So equation for power is V square by 2. This is the second relation of power. Instead of V, I can write IR also. So if I substitute V is equal to IR, then the third equation for power is I square R. So see here, we will get three equations. P is equal to VI, P is equal to V square by R, and P is equal to I square R. Now see, from this last equation, we observe that power depends on current and resistance. It means the energy dissipated in form of heat is due to resistance. If conductor is resistance-less or the resistance of the conductor is zero, then in this case, no electrical energy is dissipated in form of heat energy. But this is an ideal condition. It is not true for general. So definitely, all the resistors have some particular amount, all the conductors have some particular amount of resistance, and due to the resistance, some amount of electrical energy is dissipated in terms of heat energy. And this is called ohmic loss, right? Power loss or heat energy is produced due to resistance is called ohmic loss. Ohmic loss means what? You can remember it like this way. Ohmic loss is the power loss or a heat energy produced due to the resistance, and this is called ohmic loss. Now you observe that in bulb, filament is there. So whenever you pass the current from this bulb, so filament is heated. So most of the electrical energy is used to heat this filament, and some amount of electrical energy is converted into a light energy. So in this case also, a large amount of electric energy is lost and this energy is converted into a heat energy. Now